Justin, I had made a recording on my netbook and the quality isn't so good, and then it was too big for trying to send it up, and it took like 10 hours, and then it didn't upload and all that bullshit. So anyway, I've had to cut it in two pieces and put it back together, so that's why there's a funny glitch in the middle. And I hope you enjoy my response. Justin Michael from Red Shirt Diaries, and it is the day before St. Patrick's Day. I'm sitting in my living room here, watching you on the HD TV, with the Sony. It's got my Blu-ray player has the, YouTube app built in, so it's nice to sit here sometimes instead of downstairs. So I'm watching your very lengthy, almost long-winded review, and I've got a still picture up, so I can see The Thing, Dark Water, Stand By Me, My Life, Cujo, Chud. I know that you did Blue Valentine, and I think you did Scanners. So I want to give you some of my memories of these movies, and I'll try not to be too long-winded because I know I go way, way, way off the rails. And I'm using my netbook, which doesn't have the best video. I've got a netbook, a tablet, a desktop, a laptop, and they're all over the place. So let's see how this goes. And this is very light on my lap. Blue Valentine, we had on our DVR here for a couple of months, and then we upgraded the DVR player, so we lost that recording. But we will get to that. I like Ryan Gosling, like you do. I've watched Michelle Williams since the first episode of Dawson's Creek, and yes, I never missed an episode of Dawson's Creek. 6 years of it. Can you believe that? And that came on 1998. So I guess I was still in my 40s. I was almost a teenager when I was watching that. There we go. So I always liked Michelle Williams. I thought that she was a very authentic in that program. So I've watched her, I've seen her career blossom. And one of her movies that I really like is Dick, where she and I think it's Kirsten Dunst have some kind of run-in with Richard Nixon, Tricky Dicky. And it's actually quite a funny movie. It's not laugh out loud. It's funny, like, chuckle, but not guffaws. Now, the other one I want to talk about is well, Cujo I saw when it came out at the theater. I might have actually gone to the theater to see it because I know I read the book and I read a lot of Stephen King books, so I saw a lot of the movies. I don't think all that much of it, but I mean, it certainly has a lot of tension. And it's very, very scary in its own right. I thought the plot was awfully simplistic, but at the same time, it delivers the chills, so I shouldn't be so critical about it. Another one that you had there, My Life, I haven't seen. That I think that's one of those somebody's dying drama, I believe, isn't it? Something like that. But of course, I do like Nicole Kidman. I've liked her since Dead Calm. Have you ever seen Dead Calm? That goes back a long time ago. That's the first time I remember Nicole Kidman, the first time I remember, second time I remember Sam Neill, but it might have been the first time I watched him because I never watched The Omen 3. And Billy Zane. And boy, was he crazy. What's going on with my computer here? Okay. Anyway, but I do like her. And what else? You had Scanners there. Now, Scanners is another one I went to the movie to see. I went to the theater to see that when it was new. That was made basically in Place-Ville Marie. Now, that's French, so it's spelled Place-Ville, Ville, Marie, an underground shopping center in Montreal. And I've been in that mall. I think that's where that was filmed. Because in those days, all his films were made in Canada in his earlier career. Now, his earlier career. I think, if I recall correctly, one of the weakest things about that movie was the lead actor. I didn't think he was very good, and I cannot remember his name. to this day. And I thought it had a lot of dead parts in it, no pun intended, as well. But I think Cronenberg movies, as he got more money and became a better director, they were more polished. But those earlier ones made in Canada with Canadian tax credits and things, they were very, very rough. They often look like rough cuts, you know. But I remember I wasn't living with Ted. It's a long time ago. It's like 1980, isn't it? Something like that. I know that who I was living with. We went to the movie and we laughed for another year about the head exploding and oh, I'm gonna go scanners, you know, and we're going like this and the head blows up. But the first time the head blew up in that movie, I mean, it was too much. Like it was both horrifying and incredibly funny. But anyway, that's just me. But Cronenberg gets a lot better and. The Fly is not one of my favorite Cronenberg movies. Probably the new one that he just did, the real talky one about Freud and Carl Jung, the battling psychiatrist, basically. I like that one. The what's it called? A dangerous method, I guess it was called. I keep calling it a dangerous treatment. But another one of his that I really liked is Dead Ringers, and I recommend Dead Ringers. Dead Ringers is such a psychological, horrifying movie. It's not it, there's no monsters in it, but it's all scary because Jeremy Irons plays twin brothers, and they're gynecologists, and they're trying to do some very weird things down in the. You know, the nether regions of the women and the different wombs and things like this. And it really, really is quite a psychologically chilling movie. And Jean-Pierre Bujold is in it. And I was quite captivated. Ted and I were quite captivated by that movie. We went to the movies to see that. Let me think now, what else? What else do you have there? Oh, Chud, we saw that when it was new too. You see, the older you get, the more often I can say that, right? I saw it when it was new. I think I saw it on a VHS, and that was another one that was kind of amusing to us more than anything. If I recall, that goes something like, isn't does no? I am doing this from memory. Doesn't Chud go for cannibalistic human underground dwellers or something? Something like that. So I don't really think all that much of that movie, but I did see it. Haven't seen Dark Water. What else do you have there? The Thing. I've never been crazy about The Thing, the 82 one. I did see it on tape, I guess. No, I went. Maybe I went to the show to see it. It all runs together, but I did see it. And I've not watched any paranormal activities. Stand By Me, I'm not as crazy about it as those of you from the 80s seem to like that a lot more than I do. Another Stephen King, right? Anyway, I think I covered enough for now, but I wanted to give you some of my memories of those movies. Anyway, we'll see you around the tube, okay? A good job. And yes, mothers do rock.